Welcome to another episode of Investing Right. I am Tenny. Lot of IPOs are happening in the market. So market is on a bullish cycle. So many companies want to take advantage of the roaring bull market, what is happening, and wanted to collect their capital. So at this point of time, I had given a view of not applying for the IPOs earlier, but then specifically after a long gap in my Telegram, after reviewing the IPOs, I had given a view to subscribe to Clean Science and Technology and Tattva Chintan. So these two companies, which have recently come up with an IPO, one of them is already listed, another one is on the verge of listing. So I wanted to view these two companies. So these two companies are mainly focused into specialty chemicals. So when these IPOs came, many believed that they are highly overpriced. One of that company is already listed, the other one is on the verge of listing. So let's find out whether there is any merit in investing in these companies. So the first one in focus is Clean Science and Technology. This is incorporated in 2003. This is one of the leading chemical manufacturers globally. It manufactures functionally critical specialty chemicals such as performance chemicals, pharmaceutical intermediates, and FMCG chemicals. This company supplies its products to manufacturers and distributors in India and as well as overseas. It supplies to China, Europe, USA, Korea, Taiwan, and Japan. Who are its clients? The impressive list indeed. Bayer AG, Genex Laboratories, Nutriat International, SRF Limited, Vinadi Organics. So in 2020 financial year, it generated 69% of revenues through exports. It has its production facilities in Maharashtra. It has an aggregate installed production capacity of 30,000 MTPA. What are its competitive strengths? This company is a global leading supplier of certain chemicals, Anzol, 4-MAP, MEHO, BHA, DCC. It is strategically located close proximity to JNPT port to export its products. It has a long-term relationship with key customers. Its financial performance is very consistent. It has an international presence with export to several countries like China, USA, Korea, Japan, Taiwan. So this company has listed at around 1600. And then on, this is the only company in recent times I had given a view of subscribe and then buy on listing day. And rightly so, on the next day, though the market had fallen 150 points, this company's stock prices had gone up around 10%. I would say that if there is a correction in market, you can always consider Clean Science and Technology again. Now let's see about the second company. Second company over here is Tattva Chintan PharmaChem. This company also had its IPO 2 weeks back. It is about to list in the bourses very soon. It is incorporated in 1996. It is a chemical manufacturing company that manufactures structure directing agents, that is SDAs, phase transfer catalyst, pharmaceutical and agrochemical intermediates, and other specialty chemicals. It is amongst the largest manufacturer of SDA and zeolites in India. The company serves customers across industries, automotive, petroleum, agrochemicals and dyes and pigments, agrochemicals, dyes and pigments, paints and coatings, pharmaceutical, personal care, and others. Its products are not only sold in India, but also exported to 25 plus countries all over the world, such as USA, Germany, South Africa, China, and UK. So total export contributed 76% of total revenues from operations. So who are its clients? Let's look at the client list. It's very impressive. Merck, Bayer AG, Ipox Chemicals, Laurus Lab, Naveen Fluorine International Limited, Atul Limited, Otsuka Chemicals, SRF, Hawks Chemical Company, Manish Matrix Products, DVS Laboratories are some of its customers. So quite impressive, right? Currently, it has manufacturing facilities at Ankleshwar and Dahej in Gujarat. Now let's look at its competitive strengths. Leading manufacturer of structure directing agents and phase transfer catalyst. It has a diversified product portfolio. The global market presence with the customer base across countries and across industries is very impressive. It is strategically located manufacturing facility in Gujarat with close proximity to Hazira port, where it will make it easy for them to export. Experienced promoters, strong financial performance. So all this, that this company looks very good when it lists. So it closed its IPO on July 20th. Very soon it will be listed. So 1083 is the price at which it has issued its shares. So if you can get these shares at 1500, then I feel that one can buy these shares from the bourses on day one. Price discovery of these two companies, which has come up with IPOs very recently, has not done properly. That means what? There is still scope for an upward revision. So many of you might be thinking, brother, these aren't they very expensive issues? They are expensive. There is no doubt about that. The premiums are very high. The PE ratios and such fundamentals, if you see, they are very high. But then there is a price to pay for quality. So these quality companies can be purchased from the market itself. In case there is a market correction, try to buy these companies. These, along with other specialty companies, can really do well in next 2 years. But however, I should warn you, this is an educational video. You should try to study, do your due diligence, check with your financial advisor before making any investments. Please subscribe to this channel and join our Telegram channel, investing_right, where we talk not just about stock related things, but also on the long-term wealth generation ideas. Thanks for watching.
Investing Right. We help you to organize your investments to save for your retirement life and other major goals. In and out of mutual funds is explained, the taxes associated with them, the importance of taking the fund in the name of your minor child in order to reduce the tax burden, how to invest for your child's education, marriage, how to invest in global companies like Facebook, Google, sitting in India with an ordinary share trading account, how to evaluate a fund. What are the funds selected with such evaluation criteria? We also give an analysis of other products like exchange traded funds, real estate investment trust funds, non-convertible debentures, and stock analysis, especially of holding companies, which holds deep value. No, we don't just cover the definitions, but the in-depth analysis is given, allowing you to take the decisions depending on your risk profile. Share this video with your friends if you find it interesting. Subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click the bell icon. Come, invest right for a better tomorrow.